Good morning to the August gathering. It's my pride and privilege to be a part of this inaugural session, Center for Women Empowerment. Nimmirundha nannadai nerkonda parvayum nilathil yaarukkum anjada nerigalum timirundha gnana cherukkum irupadal semmai mother thirambuvadillaiyam. These are the igniting words from the famous poet Bharati, which portrays women empowerment. Ascertaining that excellence is not gender specific, this government college, renamed after Mahakavi as Bharati Women's College, strives its best to cater to the needs of economically weaker section of the first generation learners of North Chennai. In the recent past, we witness the risk and insecurity faced especially by women folk through media. Empowerment will be the salvation for this and will make the words of Mahakavi, Mother Thammai Ilivu Seyyum Madamaiyai Koluthuvom, come true. Women empowerment is a pivotal part in any society as they play a dominant role in the basic life of a child, and empowerment with inculcates attitudinal changes. Never demand about the success, but work for it, is a vision of our ma'am principal, the pillar of our college, who has been creating a platform for graduates to identify and chisel their talent that would transform themselves to survive in this challenging world. Now I call Madam Principal to welcome the dignitaries, Dr. Kamala Selvaraj, Director, GG Hospital, and T. Jayasudha, COO, Sankalp Cell, Chennai. Madam Principal, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Respected guests of today's inaugural function, the faculties and students of Bharati Women's College, and the guests who have joined for this inaugural function, a very warm good morning to one and all. I feel very happy to have for the inaugural function of the Center for Women Empowerment, a tiny bud that is ready to blossom in Bharati Women's College. I wish and pray God that this tiny bud should blossom and spread its fragrance throughout the campus so that many can feel the fruit. Why do the Center of Women Empowerment was the first question within me. And immediately I got an answer to the urgent need of Bharati Women's College. Because every day we see 4,500 students in our college who are really talented, but their talents are hidden. So there should be some means where the academics is being imparted to them, but apart from the academics, they have a lot within them which has to be tapped. As Mrs. Hillary Clinton said, women is the largest reservoir of untapped talent in this world. And that is, we are finding it every day before our eyes, that our students are very talented, but they are within a shell that they don't come out. So this women's center, empowerment is the main motive, will help the students with the help of all the faculty members of Bharati Women's College, so that the untapping of the talents will be done, which will empower the students, the next generation, to the next level, along with the academics, what we are imparting to them. And when I say they cross different stages, the first stage as a daughter, the second stage as a sister, the third stage as a friend, then comes a professional, then comes a wife, and then daughter-in-law. After that, she becomes a mother. Then she becomes a mother-in-law and grandmother, where she finds all the stages. And the faculty of Bharati Women's College, I think most of us have seen all the stages, and some are extra stages. So we are fulfilled women with respect to education, health. God has blessed us with everything. I think it is our duty, not only imparting knowledge, but also some service to the college as to develop the student. So this women empowerment to make our students world.
Audio.
Within us, two of the guests. They have a lot in their private life and also in their public life. Both successful women. Seeing the two successful women before us, and Dr. Kamala Selvaraj, she is successfully crossed all the stages, doing a wonderful work for the public also. Society also. So we are very proud to have her on this inaugural day for the Center of Women Empowerment. We will get the motivation from her to not like her, maybe, but to not an extent. We think that we follow her. And next is Dr. Jayasudha Tyagarajan. She is one among us. Bharati Women's College. I'm proud to have her here. Though she is in foreign service, she too has successfully balanced the market life and wonderful things for the society. So I welcome you for the inauguration of Women's Empowerment Center in our college. Next, I welcome the faculty of Bharati Women's College, without whom college will never move. I welcome the staff members of Bharati Women's College. And at this point, I would like to pay my thanks to Dr. Dharani, Department of Chemistry, for nodding her head for the deputy two staff members to organize the Center for Women Empowerment. Thank you, ma'am. And I would like to applaud Dr. Nithya and Dr. Devi for their endless efforts to start the Center of Women Empowerment. And again, one more person, Dr. Meenakshi, who has given a helping hand to support Dr. Shridevi and Dr. Nithya in the inauguration of this particular session. Next, I welcome the students of Bharati Women College who have gathered here on this inaugural function, and also those who have joined us in the inaugural function. Once again, I thank each and every one of you, and may the Center of Women Empowerment spread its fragrance so that we will see many more success stories for the coming year. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for the welcome address. Behind every successful woman is a team of other successful women. Here is one such personality who readily accepted to make the dreams of our madam principal come true. Now, I call upon Dr. Shridevi, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, Bharati Women's College, to unfurl the vision and mission of this women's self. Shridevi, ma'am.
Thank you, Meenakshi ma'am. உலக வாழ்க்கையின் தேரவும் போது பற்பலும் இலக சீருடை நாட்டின் யாவும் சென்று திலக மாணவரையார் தங்கள் பாரத தேசம் முன்பு உழைத்திடல் வேண்டுமா? விலகி வீட்டிலோர் தொந்தில் வளர்ந்ததை உங்கள் பெண்கள் விரைவில் உழைக்கலாம் என்ற மகளிரின் மேம்பாட்டுக்காக பல வருடங்களுக்கு முன்னரே பாடினார் மகாகவி. அந்த பாரதியின் பெயரால் விளங்கும் எம் கல்லூரியில் அப்பாடலுக்கு உயிர் கொடுத்து மகளிர் மேம்பாட்டு முதல்வருக்குலர்லி அமௌங் கவர்மெண்ட் காலேஜஸ் டு ஹாவ் எம்பவர்மெண்ட் அவர் மிஷன் இஸ் டு எம்பவர் அண்ட் எக்விப் விமென் with all skill sets so that they break the social, economic and financial clutches and strengthen themselves to face all odds of the society. The vision of the center is to make the life of women more safe and sustainable. She should understand the purpose of her life, attain fulfillment and also improve the lives of those around her. Through the center, we propose to organize three kinds of programs. Entrepreneurial development for women. This is focused towards the self-employment of the women at large. Skill development. The students will be trained with the necessary skills so that they become more employable. Organizing seminars, conferences, and workshops for the aspiring faculty. We hope and pray. afraid to turn each word into action. We solicit your wishes and support to make the center serve for the betterment of the society. Thank you. Meenakshi ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now it's time to pray the Almighty. Salutations to the Divine Spirit disperse positive energy around us that gives us strength to achieve success in all our endeavors. Now I request all the participants to join us for the virtual lighting of lamp. Now I request Madam Principal to introduce Dr. Kamala Selvaraj to the gathering. Over to you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Dr. Kamala Selvaraj. The name, I really don't know whether I can utter the name because she looks very simple in her look, but she's a very powerful person. She's the one who creates, nurtures, and transforms mankind. I'm very proud to have you here, ma'am, on this occasion. Dr. Kamala Selvaraj is a renowned gynecologist who commissioned the first test tube baby of South India and third in India in the year 1990. Above all, she was the first research scholar in reproductive physiology in Tamil Nadu. Her achievements have started in the year 1991 and it continues. In the year 1991, she got the Rajiv Gandhi Unity Award. Then she got the Best Lady Doctor Award. Then she got the Doctor's Day Award, Award for Distinguished Medical Service by State Women's Forum, Madras, Seva Ratna Award, Jeevan Bharati Award, the Most Outstanding Women in the Field of Medicine, Women Empowerment Award, Best Motherhood Award, Sigaram Totta Pengal Award, Lifetime Achievement Award, Woman Extraordinary Award, Supermom and Daughter Award, Rajiv Gandhi Memorial National Integration Award, Mahila Sironmani Award, Paramacharya Award, and a lot more to say, which time doesn't permit, ma'am, so I stop for this. And apart from this, she was the first one to give the first gamete interfallopian tube transfer twins of South India, the first frost baby of South India, the first surrogate baby of India, the first test tube baby to a 50-year-old woman in India. She programmed and delivered the first baby with her own technique called Fruity in India. And she was the one to give first pregnancy in a single woman in India, first ICSI baby of South India, South India's first baby triplets from frozen embryo, India's first frozen oocyte baby, India's first twin baby by vitrification method, South India's first test tube turns India's first mother. Even that pride goes to Dr. Kamala Selvaraj. Ma'am, again, I have to read a lot, ma'am, as the time doesn't permit, and we want you to share with us your ideas how we too can successfully live in this society, balancing both your private life and the public life. We want your suggestions. So I stop with this, all your laurels, and I invite you, ma'am, to share with us how you are so successful in our life, and that will inspire us and motivate us to move ahead. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for the nice introduction. Think like a queen. A queen is not afraid of failures. Failure is another stepping stone to greatness. This phrase will be apt for our guest of the day, Dr. Kamala Selvaraj, leading gynecologist who would have crossed many hurdles as a woman to reach this present status, the director, GG Hospital. She is extending an helping hand to the women community to overcome their problem of infertility, which is ever growing in the present scenario, maybe due to the lifestyle changes. Now, I call upon you, madam, to deliver the inaugural address.
Thank you, one and all. Thank you, Gladys, and for introducing me in such an elaborate way. Am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you are.
So, I'm supposed to be empowered. I'm supposed to be all one soul and also. So, I think I should start from my childhood, the way I'm brought up and where you change and where you become bold and take actions, okay? So, I was born in a Brahmin family, very orthodox. My mother was educated up to 7th standard and arranged marriage. And we were in village, Pudukota, then came when I was 5 years to Chennai, to this area, Dr. Thirumurthy Nagar. Until today, I still live in this same area. And we were brought up rumba stricta Brahmin family. My mother was very strict and we were very, very orthodox. We were not allowed to go. Sandhya Kala Achana Valila Pomudyada. Now, what is Sandhya Kala? Many don't know. And in the night, we can never step out and not without somebody with you all the time. Till today, that holds what happened in my childhood. குழந்தையில அப்பனா கூட யாரும் இல்லாம எங்களை அனுப்பிச்சதே இல்லை. இன்னை மட்டும் யூ கேன் ஆஸ்க் எனிபடி எனிவே, ஐ எம் நெவர் சீன் அலோன் பை மை செல்ஃப். ஐதர் சம்படி ஒர்க்கிங் வித் மீ ஆர் மை சிஇஓ ஆர் மை ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆர் மை சர்வெண்ட் அட் ஹோம், சம்படி அக்கம்பனிஸ் மீ ஆல் த டைம். திஸ் இஸ் ஒன் வே டு ப்ரொடெக்ட் யோர் செல்ஃப், டு ஹாவ் சம்படி. அண்ட் ஆல்சோ த என்வாயன்மெண்ட் யூ ஆர் ப்ராட் அப் ஆட்ஸ் ஹியர் அண்ட் த changed your life. It is like how my grandmother was, very meticulous and cleanliness. Even ஒரு பருக்க ரைஸ் கூட இலையில உட்கார்ந்து தான் சாப்பிடுவோம். விடோ, ஒன்லி ஒன் மீல் அ டே. ஒரு அரிசி விழுந்தா கூட அது ஒரு ஊசி குத்தில சம்படி யூஸ் டு தட் பாரதியார் வாட்டோ, அதை டிப் பண்ணி ஷீல் டேக் இட், ஷீல் சி தட் நத்திங் இஸ் வேஸ்டட், நத்திங் இஸ் த்ரோன் அவே. அட்லீஸ்ட் மீதி இருந்தால் பிச்சைக்காரனுக்கு, ரா பிச்சைக்காரனுக்காவது கொடுக்கணும். We also grow up the way. I don't waste anything at all. Everything is, if I know I'm not using it, it doesn't matter what the price. I immediately give it to somebody who will use it. So this is not about empowerment. It is your quality. To become somebody, you need a stimulus. My parents were, though my mother is not fully educated, she is a hard worker. She works all the time at home. We learned how to துணி எப்படி துவைக்கணும், அது எப்படி இருக்க புழியணும், எப்படி உதறி வெயிலில் ஒரு சுருக்கம் இல்லாமல் காய வைக்கணும், எப்படி நீட்டாக மடித்து வைக்கணும். அதுலேருந்து சமைக்கிறது வி நெவர் லேர்ன் டில் வி பிகேம் அ டாக்டர். பட் வி வாட்ச்ட் த சில்ட்ரன் வாட்ச் யூ ஆல் த டைம். நீங்கள் என்னவோ பண்ணுறீங்க, ஏதோ பேசுறீங்க, ஏதோ தப்பாக பண்ணினா கூட இட்ஸ் பீங் வாட்ச் பை தம் ஆல் த டைம். ஸோ ஐ வாட்ச் மை கிராண்ட் மதர்ஸ் behavior, how she saves things, எப்படி ஆடை எடுப்பா, எப்படி முறுக்கு சுடுவா, அதுலேருந்து நான் வாட்ச் பண்ணியிருக்கேன். அதே மாதிரி அம்மா எப்படி ஒன்று ஒன்றும் நைட்டு ஆச்சுன்னா ஒவ்வொரு ரூமாக பூட்டி பெட்டுக்கடியில் யாரும் இல்லையா சேஃப்டிக்காக பார்த்து பண்ணுறத நான் வாட்ச் பண்ணியிருக்கேன். எங்கள் அப்பாவும் ஆல் த டைம் ஆன் த ரன், இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு சேரில் உட்காந்து கூட பார்த்ததில்ல. ஹி வில் ரிவர்ஸ் த சேர் அண்ட் சிட் லைக் திஸ் நோ யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் கெட் ஆஃப் லைக் தட். அந்த மாதிரி அவளை பார்த்துருக்கேன். காலம்புற சீக்கிரமா 4 மணிக்கு எழுந்துப்பா, பட் அதே மாதிரி சீக்கிரம் 7 மணிக்கு தூங்கிடுவா. அந்த ரெஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தட் 4 to 7 தேர் ஆன் ரோலர் ஸ்கேட்டர். ஐ ஹவ் நெவர் சீன் தம் சிட் சாட், காசிப் ஆர் டூ சம்திங். தே ஒர்க் ஆல் தி டைம். ஸோ போத் த குவாலிட்டிஸ் டுகெதர் ஹஸ் கம் டு ஆல் அஸ் ஃபோர் சில்ட்ரன். நோபடி, வி ஆர் ஃபோர் கேர்ள்ஸ். தே ட்ரைட் ஃபார் அ பாய். ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி தே டிடன்ட் கெட் அ பாய். And we four are close and we four are all eminent in our own field. One is my sister, Dr. Revathi Swaminathan in the United States. She is a radio-oncologist and she is a wonderful woman, came out in magazine and wrote. Just now she retired and she's in St. Louis. I'm second. I'm here forever in Chennai. I'm born in Pudukot, Trichy, but from then 5 years I'm here only and I'll be here. And third sister is Narayani Ganesh. Most of you might know about her. She's in Times of India. She's in the Speaking Tree. She's the editor of the Speaking Tree. And she's very well known and she's a much wanted journalist, because if she is sent to Brahmaputra River on the boat, by the time the boat comes back and reaches the land, she would have already typed everything. It would have gone to Times of India, the first to be published. By the time she reaches Delhi, it will be already in the news. So she was the one to interview Dalai Lama. One whole page came about Dalai Lama. So we all work very hard. My younger sister Gigi also same. They work in-house all the time. And I work in the hospital from morning to evening. And what you do, what you choose should be your dream. And you should enjoy what you're doing. You should have a passion. Then only you can do what you want to do. You can't be forced. Parents cannot force you. When I was 16 years, we finished our schooling. My daddy asked, "Well, you want to get married now? Should I look for a groom? Or you want to do something, pursue some career?" Then we said, both of us, we said no, because the difference between me and Narayani is 8 years. So he asked both of us. So we said, we don't want to get married. We want to do medicine. So he turned heaven and earth and got his seat in Manipal Medical College. There we studied very well and came up. And so it was a passion. It was not forced. You can never force your child to do something. You should find out what is her ambition, what she wants to do, and you should encourage her to do it. That is for her to come up in life, to be really empowered and shine. If you think I'm shining, it's because they allowed me to do what I wanted to do. And I was mad about medicine and discovering something. I want to discover something. And patients who had fallopian tube block, they can never have a child in their lifetime. The husbands had second marriage and children. It was heartbreaking. And then only I came across in a paper and I did it. It's a separate chapter altogether. If anybody wants to know about it, in GG Hospital, you have, what is that? Dream Come True book that tells me about 100 pages, my journey, that you will know how to come up in life. And again, for ladies, now what we are going through, you know, as you say, the present condition, there we had nuclear, now we are nuclear family, that time they had the whole family together, where we were protected from all side. Maybe they was molested also, I don't know. But we were together, somebody to support you all the time. Today, you are standing alone, husband, wife, and children, and so much of competition within the house because both are going for work. Unless both works 90%, you cannot give the best education. You cannot have the at least average life. You need one vehicle at least. So it has become a necessity. What happens to the children? Are they fed properly? A nutritious diet is given? Are the homework looked into? You go and meet the principal in school? You have to manage all this. That is only efficiency of a woman or empowerment. You should be able to do all this. You have to cook previous night. You chart out your plan, what you want, buy it, keep it ready. If it not gets spoiled, you can cut it and keep it ready. So, thalichi edukra madri. Adhe mari, the books are arranged for the children. And you can sleep just for 6 hours. And you see that everything is done properly. And husband and wife, two children, your turn to bathe the children today, my turn to bathe this child. So, you take turns even making coffee. Today, I'm going to make coffee and give for husband and wife. Means next day, the husband should do. Or you keep on whole week distributed. Your earning, you don't be dependent on anybody. You should have a common account where you put 50% of both your salaries in one account. That is for the house expenditure, vegetables, paying the servants, and all the child education and all the tuition and all. The other half is put on individual name where you spend for your family. You want to give for your mother and father. You want to gift a present your friend for birthday or something. Something like that you should go on doing, separate it like that. Therefore, you have enough money for everything. And also, you should teach the girl child, give her an ambition or to encourage. My daddy will say, try to reach the unreachable star. Go and reach the star. You should go to that. And you should put your footprint in the time of life. You should be there. So always, my dream was, we always, you think we should do something extraordinary, something different, something out of the world. But this opportunity has been given to you by God. It just doesn't come and fall on your lap. You keep on looking in your particular field, and it should come when you pray God, you respect your elders, you get their blessings all give you a good way. I was thinking that I was praying to God, I lost 2 diamond bangles, I got it today. So it's like when you pray and you say, you don't do anything wrong, don't harm anybody, don't tell lies for petty things. All this goes to make your good self and makes you empowered. God helps you. When I started my first test tube baby, I was only one. அட் பிரீட் மைஸ் எலியெல்லாம் வளர்த்து எலிக்கு தனியா கூண்டு கட்டி அதோட முட்டையை எடுத்து அது கண்ணுக்கே தெரியாது அந்த மைக்ரோஸ்கோப். அதுக்கு எலி சக்குந்தலான்னு ஒரு வேலைக்காரி கூடவே வச்சுட்டு அவ எடுத்து கொடுத்து நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டெஸ்டி பேபி பிறந்த உடனே அப்படியே ஜே 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 நீங்க கூட்டம், எனக்கு சாமான இல்ல, அதுவும் இல்ல, ஒன்னும் இல்ல, சொல்லி கொடுக்க ஆள் இல்ல, யாருக்கும் சொல்லி கொடுக்க முடியல, அதுக்கு எஃபிஷியன்ட் பீப்புள் இல்ல, ரொம்ப கஷ்டப்பட்டேன். ஐ தாட் ஐ வாஸ் கோயிங் மேட், பட் ஐ ஓவர் கேம் ஆல் தட். ஐ குட் டூ இட். That is the willpower and the courage you need to build. Willpower and the courage, dhairyam nichayama romba dhairyama irukkanum, appo dhaan thaniya othar idellam panna mudiyum. Idhu maari pandrathukku adukku na enna eduthupena, kadavula vinayakara vendipen. Amma will say you should have a guru. Guru vandu will guide you in every way. So choose somebody among here. Yaaraga othra guru vechukko. Na so eppadi na vechik mudiyum? Ellarum tappu pannuva, ellarum emlama pannuva, enakku eppadi theriyum? Na vinayakara dhaan en guruva eduthupen. Because I know he is sitting in one place, he won't do anything wrong. So guru, I have my hospital Vinayakan, he is my guru. And then when he is your guru, you keep and pray to him. And the next one can be your parents or your grandmother. So when I went to do the testy baby, appa amma kuppu namaskaram panni party namaskaram pannite, then only I entered the testy baby theater. And I didn't have money, mind you. The hospital I got on six grounds was behind my daddy's house. I told my papa, just give me that ground, pa, gift it to me. Naane aspatri kattikiren. So when he gifted the land to me through Bank of Baroda down the road, I pledged the land, got 20 lakhs, 23.2 lakhs, and I started building the hospital. The amount of the hospital was that by one agent. So I said, 1 year you have holiday period to pay the money, 1 year. So I have to finish it before that. So how will I do? I asked the contractor, engineer, architect, how long will it take? What will delay your process of doing the building? He said, steel and cement. That's very hard to get. I said, leave that to me. I will go and get it. I found out where they sell the cement near the shipyard. I used to go and fight like a... They don't know who I was, but I used to, my 300 bags over, I want immediately. Same way steel was in this Greens Road here. There was a person, my daddy's friend, even my daddy was doing a construction. I said, I want steel. I practically, like a child, I went and fought with them and got ahead of time all these things. Therefore, the building superstructure was done in 6 months and the final finish was 1 year. But before that, 9th month, I made my patients come from Mambalam in that wet ground, and I started practicing from there itself without the building being completed or inaugurated. So when the 3 more months I could make money and put for the building, then at the end of 1 year, I prayed to God that if I'm starting January 31st digging, I send the mud to Periwal Sankaracharya to be blessed. And then I want to inaugurate on January 31st, 1 year. So in between, I went to Nagapattinam and Velanganni and Darga, all the 3 temples with my parents. I prayed to them and came back. If I finish, I'll come back again. Correct on January 31st of the next month, I inaugurated the hospital, got my gold, worked day and night. I used to keep headlights for them to finish during the day. So you have to, if you want to achieve, you have to work for that. Not under stress or tension. It should be a pleasant that you're achieving something and you want to do something good, and you persevere and you never let it go down. And there will be cries. You will be crying. I have cried when something is lost in the hospital. சும்மா பேசின் அடியில உள்ள ஒரு தண்ணி போடுது, அது காணும்னாலும் அழுவேன், இது காணாலும் அழுவேன், ஒரு நாள் டிலே ஆச்சுனாலும் அழுவேன். பட் ஷேம்லெஸ்லி ஐ டென்ட் கேர் அபவுட் இட். ஸோ அந்த இன்ஜினியர் அப்பப்ப நான் சமாதானப்படுத்துறேன், முடிஞ்சிருமா கவலைப்படாத, முடிஞ்சிருமா கவலைப்படாதான்னு சொல்லிட்டேன். அப்புறம் போய் ஆரம்பிச்ச உடனே எனக்கு ஐம் டெல்லிங் யூ ஹவு ஐ எம் எம்பவர்ட். தேர்ஃபோர் ஐ எம் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் யூ பீப்புள் டு பி லைக் தட். அதே மாதிரி நாங்கள் காரை நாங்கள் வெளியில போறச்சு, எங்கள் வீட்டில் வந்து நாங்கள் தனியாக போனது இல்லை. அதனால தான் somebody comes with you all the time. You never, not that she should be a coward, that she can't go alone, but she should know yara paakano, eppadi dress pananum, yara paatha sirikkalam, yara paatha sirikka kudadu. But best what they said, thariya paathu walk pannadhu better. Now and then you look up just to see you're not banging onto anybody. Keep on the ground. When I enter car etti irangina na thariya paathinde dhaan nanappen. Occasionally I'll lift my eyes if somebody is wishing me or something, then smile again. It saves you a lot of trouble. It saves you to avoid whom you don't want to talk. It saves you from many problems. So do that. Train your girl children to be like that. When you have a girl child and boy child, treat them equally. You wash your plate, you wash your plate. you sell the plate today, you sell the plate today. And dressing also, you teach them how to be modestly dressed. Not that it should be showy, but you don't want to attract anybody from outside. So you teach them to dress modestly. And after Sandhya Kalam, cannot go alone. Always have somebody to accompany you. And night time, it should be a gang of people. You know what's happening today to everybody. And work relentlessly, day and night. Day and night you work and do what is right. And you should learn everything from cooking, from stitching, from, of course, if a padipip, it's very bad to go through the webinar all the time. But we have no choice because we're going through pandemic. So how are you going to overcome this? We'll be getting injections, so immunization. And when you, two children, the Christian, I told you, two children equal point, it's the culpata, the end. My friend in Dharmavali in London, she used to say that. She'll be rolling on the bed today happily. Yena, her husband coffee panano. Adhe mari culpata, the end. So you teach the children about character, education, how to come up in life, how do you work, how do you coordinate if you have an office, how do you coordinate? Choose, keep your secretary and two other people. Be kind to them, be nice to them, and watch carefully. Therefore, they're doing the right thing and not the wrong thing. Because I found in this hospital when I joined, my parents didn't tell me that people will tell lies, people will steal money, and you are studied medicine to make money. So when the minute I finished, I wanted a clinic near my house. I found a room and it was 200 rupees rent per month. So when I went, I took my daddy's secretary's daughter to come and help me. And then people used to come, they used to say, how much to pay? I was blinking. I said, ayyo, ipdi onnu iruka en theriyade amma sollali enna pandrathu, what to say? I was blinking. Then I said, oru rupa kudunga na 50 paisa. And avanga da naale kudukrom no eridhi vechirukom oru book full a ache appuram. But anyway, by end that 200 rupees, it was 120 rupees, 120 rupees I made that month in spite of having so much of account. Then I told my mother, you never told me that they'll ask for panam. Odane she said, ona panam sambadhikka education kudukala, we wanted you to do service to humanity. You need money, I'm not saying you should not make money, but more than that, service should be first before you make money. So you should teach your workers, you have to watch them. You don't know who is good, who is bad when they come. We have discovered so many things in the hospital and we thought, now we are perfect, everything is okay, everything is corrected. Even then we found a mistake. The electrical things, what you when you have a petty cash lady and you have two boys, you go, they got the book from that shop, they stole a book and they were writing and taking money. How much they took? I think 50,000 rupees worth. One day we found same handwriting, same thing. Why same thing is going? And we found and we dismissed all the three. We got the money back. So when you can't just take the things are granted, now everything is settled, I'm fine. No, you should keep on watching, having an eye everywhere, checking everything, improving your goal. Go higher and higher and higher. If you have achieved something today, it's not enough. You need to do something better. So you sit together, form tabulations, you know, for us. Say something happens to a patient, we miss an injection. Udane, I call the people involved. Why this has happened? Why has it happened like this? Now, what are we going to do next? Then we form a tabulation. Same way in the OP, some treatment is missed. Again, we make big, big files. Therefore, we don't make mistakes. So everything that happens, we immediately make a chart, a flow chart and correction. If you keep on doing that, correcting every mistake and make a tabular column and you keep it in a file. A nurse comes, we give her a book. What has happened in the hospital? What all you should do when this happens? So that nobody is disturbed and the patient is immediately saved. So this is how you should be to reach the unreachable star. You want to put your footprint in the foot of time, the sand of time, and try hard and make a goal and don't be scattered. Man, I won't do this today. I won't do this soon. No, you should fix what you're good at, not what you want. What you're good at is important than choosing like what you want to do. I want to be a doctor, but I'm scared of blood. No way. My sister Narayani said, you're not going to be a doctor. No, I'm very scared of blood. She loves writing so much. So my daddy said, you'll become a journalist. She is a journalist. So you must choose, go towards your ambition, go towards what your liking is, and then you will shine and you'll become an entrepreneur. You'll become empowered woman and lead your life. I think my time is over. Anything else you want I think I've told enough about myself like that. From car driving, for drawing and painting, swimming, knitting, everything I know. So you should get yourself involved in some hobbies that will distract your mind. And keep, have a healthy food to eat. Therefore, you set an example to your child by not eating junk food. Once in a while, you can. Once in a while, you cannot go to McDonald's. Once in a while, you can go to Domino's. But just once in a while, once in a month. But apart from that, teach them what is healthy food. What is junk food? What you should not do? What you can do? What is good for you? All this is very, very important. Okay. So that is how you bring up your child. Encourage your child, please. Don't hit them and say you got 0 or 5 is very bad. No. You come and sit next to the child and say, come on now. What is your deficiency? What is your weak point? Tell me. You sit with them and teach them. It happened that when my son was studying in Chidambaram, before the exam, I went to check. Then the principal said, you can take off all the 3 boys from Chennai and go back. Come next for the next exam. Next time, let them write. I was horrified. I said, why, sir? They don't know anything at all. Half the time, there's no attendance also for them. Because they were ragged. They were ragged all the time. So every weekend and before that, 3-4 days, they hardly attended the college, I believe. So they were hiding and doing that. I said, okay, sir, thank you. So anyway, even if I allow him to write, he's going to fail. So I took him home, kept, and in between my hospital time, I got all the latest exam, no quarterly, that final exam papers of anatomy, physiology, biochemistry. I got everything, made him 3 books. I sat and dictated the question and answer to them. I took what all is common, no, what is repeated. Just took those and dictated the question and answer. I made him by heart and tell me, no. So that time this child knew, then I was attending both hospital and him. Then the child knew how to read. Oh, this is how we read. This is how, and he did very well. He is my surgeon. He is DM and gastroenterology plus MS general surgeon. He's doing all my endoscopy, hysterectomy, all the operations for me he's doing. I taught him everything. So you should know your child. You know your child's intentions. Shower your love and affection whether you have time or not. Somehow, at least I love you. One word is enough, and hug and kiss is enough. It makes them so happy when you touch them. Touch is the best love and affection. So, and hugging also. And understand the difficulties, understand the problem. See, if you see the face of the child, something wrong, you talk to them, what is your problem? Something is troubling your mind. Anything you tell me, I'm ready to accept it. No? And then there are so many things that can be done to become an empowered woman, being popular, bold. Strength should be bold. Bold to talk out your ideas and also be very swift and don't be lazy. Your place, you work, when I come, I just see that my table is neat, very neat. And then only I'll start to work. If something's not all right, I'll immediately check on them. Any questions? I think I'm done. Lunarachana.
Thank you, ma'am, for your inspiring speech in a simple way, sharing our personal experiences. Mm-hmm. Now the floor is open for discussion.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
This is Nitya from Department of Chemistry.
Okay.
Just I want to ask you one basic question. Nowadays, everywhere we can see the fertility center in and around. So they are giving so many advertisements also. So what is the reason for this, ma'am? Because a decade back, we don't have this type of the facility and everyone didn't go for it. Nowadays, it was like after a marriage, immediately they are waiting for 1 or 2 years, immediately they are going to the fertility center. What is the problem for the current people or current generation people? Is it because of the junk food or the lifestyle or what is the basic problem because of it? Just I want to know it, ma'am.
Yeah, yesterday when there was a group of families and the child marriage and she's kept in the parents' place and when she matures, she's sent to the husband's house. And this child, there's always 10 years difference. That is how you respect a older person. As the equal age, you start fighting. But 10 years difference, they learn, oh, somebody respectful, no? So whatever the person does, the child doesn't know to refuse. And she gets pregnant, delivers a 9th month. And then she's lactating the child. while lactating itself, after 1.5-2 years, she gets naturally pregnant. She's still lactating. Then she delivers the next child. So in a whole lifespan of 45 years, she'll be having 9 children and menstruated about 10 or 11 times only. That was the days, those days. And those days, there were no diseases like that. Fresh atmosphere, natural food, no, all organic. And the people, the ladies' work was only to cater for the house and older person and deliver and feed the child. But today, in this modern world, people want to study. Okay, you study, all right, fine. But then there's no end to it. You want to study further. And then again, there's no end. Again, you want to study more. By the time you think about marriage, your parents, they'll say they're searching. They never get a match. I don't know why. When I ask why you didn't marry, you're still searching, you're not getting. I don't know how. And when they marry also, there is some disparity or something they don't like. In 1 to 1.5 years, they want to divorce. And then by accident, if they have a child also, the child usually goes with the mother. And then this one has no children. No, what is the problem? We don't know. But anyway, another 2 couple get married. Then leave alone that marriage. And then as the age goes, God has created uterus to deliver at a particular time. In the vayasukulla nee kuzhandha pettukano illa na enga pore, uterus says. Na engren oru kuzhandhaiya thookkuradhukku. Adhukku dhaan na created. Adhu vandu usually in the 18 to 25 years kulla, if you finish your family, all the problems, all you're young, energetic, you can run behind. Your parents are young, are waiting for a grandmother. The best gift of God for aging is grandchildren. So when they are aging, amma yeng karcha neenga vandu adukku na vasathu pidra. By the time you deliver, there's nobody to take care of the baby. So at young age, you can deliver. 18, 20, you get married, you get a child immediately, give the child to your grandparents, do whatever you want. The best person who can look after your grandchildren or your parents. And then when you don't do that, you marry, but still you family plan for some time. Your family plan, then your uterus is hanging in the cutty form of fibroid cutty. Or you get endometriosis, chocolate cyst of the ovary, pelvic upper, you do abortion of the first child, you get pregnant, you want to terminate because you're not prepared for it. And you didn't take the caution too. So either you take tablets or you do DNC. That introduces infection. Infection goes and blocks the tubes. Again, you get fibroids, you get endometriosis. And the man is under stress all the time. They have very low count and they are having hot underwear in hot water, bathing and hot atmosphere. The count is very low because they're also under high stress. All this causes infertility.
Thank you, ma'am.
The question? But did you understand what I said?
Yeah, ma'am. It's all because of the stress.
Please, right. Women get married before 25, please. 25, they should have a child. They don't have to have for 2-3 years.
But I don't think it is possible nowadays. 25, they...
My daughter got married, immediately had a child, again unchild, and again unchild. First is 18 years, approved 16 years and 15 years. 3 tall, pretty children. And I was the happiest grandmother, I think. Happiest grandmother. I used to work in the hospital, have the baby in the deluxe room. I used to run up and down and take care of the child for almost 6 months in the same hospital. It's such a pleasure for your parents. So don't, please make them happy. It is possible. That is also women empowerment.
Are there any other questions? Participants? Any other questions?
They won't okay. Like to ask because I told what they don't like.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am, for sparing your valuable time with us to clarify our doubts.
Thank you. Nice meeting all of you. Hope I put something into your brain, some ideas at least. Okay. Thank you so much for calling me. Okay. Bye-bye. Best
thank,
of
you,
best
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Now we call upon our Madam Principal to introduce the speaker, Jayasudha, COO Sankalp Cell.
Dr. Jayasudha Yagarajan,
Chief Operating Officer Sankalp Sen. Before continuing with this, I would like to introduce her as Dr. Jayasudha Thyagarajan, a senior faculty member of Bharati Women's College. That gives me more proud, I must say. Now she is the Chief Operating Officer, Sankalp Sen, at National Instructional Media Institute, MSDE, Government of India. She is an experienced research officer with a demonstrated history of working for the higher education industry. She is skilled in lecturing, educational technology, instructional design, curriculum development, and public speaking. She is a strong education professional focused in TESOL, teaching of English to speakers of other languages from TESOL Institute, Virginia, and she has done a certificate in critical thinking from American English Institute, University of Oregon, USA. Her UGC project, Enhanced Communication Skills of First Generation Learners of Government Colleges, have paved the way to train students and place them in multinational companies. She has designed English language curriculum for schools named as SCERT, Communicative English, and the next book is MS Scheme, Communicative English Textbook for Polytechnic Students. She has completed Tamil Nadu Innovative Initiative Project on Content and Language Integrated Learning in Enhanced Communication Skills. A skill framework called Strategic English Across the Curriculum has been developed to meet the CEFR levels, starting from young learners to tertiary level industry needs of their employment. She has conducted many training programs. She has represented Tamil Nadu Higher Education Department in the Global Week and made presentation as a visiting partner in King's College, London. She is working on a project proposal on corpus linguistics in collaboration with Dr. Jane Evison, lecturer, Seal University of Nottingham, UK. She is a member of TESOL Journal's editorial board, member of Literary Endeavor Journal, member of Journal for the Study of English Linguistics. She has completed UGC major projects worth of rupees 10 lakhs, an action research to design modules to enhance and hone the communication skills of first generation learners of government colleges in 2012. She has published many articles in national and international journals, anthologies, books, both national and international, translations, TANI modules, and also she has got the pride of holding post like research officer in Tamil Nadu State Council of Higher Education and DGM Director, National Instructional Media Institute, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Government of India. Now she is into the creation of short-term and long-term skill training under the now regulatory body, NCVET. She is also leading a World Bank funded project, Sangal. Ma'am, we wish you all success in all the endeavors in the coming years too. And as the time doesn't permit, I cannot read everything, as your list also is a very long list to say about you. And now it is time, ma'am, for having your ideas about women empowerment. Over to Dr. Meenakshi.
Thank you, ma'am, for the brief introduction. The force of women determined to raise cannot be equated. And so is our guest, Dr. Jayasudha, who had set her goal to a different dimension, worked towards it, and now the COO of Sankalp Sen. I am proud to call Jayasudha, a member of our Bharatiyan family, to deliver a special lecture. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Meenakshi. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. First, I would like to congratulate Bharati Women's College for this very big step towards initiating a Center for Women Empowerment, because I know it will definitely work in Bharati. Thank you for this opportunity to be there as one of the special invitees on this important occasion in Bharati Women's College. First, I would like to just have a few thoughts shared about why I am where I am. Actually, I was not meant for teaching because normally it is understood that most of our families, when there is a girl and the girl is educated, would want us to land in a safest job, which helps us manage both the family and the kids, which would be either a government job or a teaching profession or in the bank. I was completely against it. My pursuit of an MA in English with a UGC JRF was only to become a journalist. Little did I want to continue in government service. Nevertheless, it was convenient for me when I came to Bharati with a 6-month-old baby that my daughter was. It was easy for me to rise. But then I would place on record Dr. Pushpa's motivation that she nurtured in me, who is not just my guide from Bharati Women's College, but she is also more than a mother to me. So she was the one who actually showed me avenues on things that one could do differently even within a government situation. And she also exposed me to the nuances in which the government student enrollment itself provided a lot of scope for experimentation, thereby uplifting not only one's own dreams, but also an entire generation of students. And it was really overwhelming when she said, but still I had my own doubts about it. I should say that all this happened because of the kind of research that I wanted to undertake, which was not everybody else's cup of tea, to do things that everyone else would not want to venture into, which actually does not have much relevance within the scenario of your everyday classroom teaching, because you get to teach what is allotted. But that is where I was able to even make a difference, because I was able to carve a niche for myself in adopting this outcome-based education, outcome-based teaching, where the toughest of subjects were given to me, like phonetics or language and linguistics, but still students actually were able to actually make it with a very meaningful score, not just a mere pass. And it was not from rote learning. So I should first place on record that the students of Bharati Women's College, though from working class families and are first generation learners, if you really have the conviction and deliver something that is meaningful, they always travel along with you. This was something that made my entire view of working as a faculty and in a government scenario undergo a complete sea change. So I started taking steps towards working on classroom reforms, which were actually personally under my control, given whatever was the curriculum or whatever was the courses that I was offered to teach within the department. So there I was able to strike a little success with my PhD, which further motivated me to take up a UGC project, which actually opened up more avenues because I was handling three things at a time. And I learned for the first time that even with a small child going to school, you could still do multitasking and manage so many things while also maintaining a home well, where I think Dr. Kamala Selvaraj was right. I was actually the ELF coordinator. I was also the project genesis trainer, and I was also running a UGC workshop, and I was running a own lab of my own, which was actually the lab was installed with the UGC support. But then each one of these roles actually interlinked, and I was able to see a pattern, and it gave me an opening to try things out. And at that point in time, there was so much that was happening as a neo-colonial setup, where the British Council and the Cambridge Assessment Services, all of them actually were trying to exploit the educational scenario, where the academic scenario had not woken up to the changing scenario, where with liberalization in education, the profile of students who enrolled in arts and science colleges had completely changed. But little did we take stock of what the children brought along with them, where they came from, what their personal and academic backgrounds were. So all of these were not taken into account. Now, this gave me an opportunity also to work on something parallel with the CEFR, the Common European Framework of Reference, and that brought me to the SEAC, the Strategic Essentials Across the Curriculum. It has been completely modified now to map all kinds of domains, not just English alone. So originally it started off as Strategic Essentials Across the Curriculum, which was from 2014 to 16 after my immersion in Nottingham through the Tamil Nadu Study Abroad program. But now have been able to scale and map it to match all the domains with the TANI experiment that I had with the Tamil Nadu State Council for Higher Education. And today it has been aligned with the National Skills Qualifications Framework. Now let me come to what actually means skilling. And what is it Bharati can plan out to do through the Center for Women Empowerment through the various skill programs that Dr. Sridevi was talking about? First is the definition of skill itself is the ability to do something, especially as a result of training. So if you're trained to do, say, X, Y, Z at a certain degree, one should be able to see those of them who are trained to be able to do it at that level. Number two, what is outcomes? Somebody who should be able to do something and perform that at the end of the said training at a specified level. Now, when I talk about skills and outcomes, I should also give a little overview on what the National Skills Qualifications Framework is. Now, this National Skills Qualification Framework is something that aligns the level of skill training from 1 to 10 levels. It has 10 levels. You can Google and find the notification which is available. The Gazette notification on NSQF is available online for free. Now, it has 10 levels where 1, 2, and 3 actually are for the unorganized sector. There are so many masons and artisans like carpenters, people who work with construction sites, people who are plumbers, people who are electricians, who do it because most of them in the family have done it, or somebody, some acquaintance has done it, and they have taken it up only by observation and practical hands-on experience and not any formal training. So these people come under this 1, 2, and 3. When we think of level 4, most of the ITI training is at level 4 or 5, and most of the polytechnics training is from 5 to 6. So when we talk about NSQF, we talk about 10 levels, and 1, 2, and 3, I said, are those that are for people who do it in the informal setup, and 4, 5, and 6 is the most common one where 10th pass outs, people who have cleared their SSLC, take up through the ITIs or through the polytechnics. The rest of the ones from 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 are a little higher in level. Level 4 training enables one to do certain things at their own pace and at their own level. Whereas 5, they not only can do it themselves, but also to some extent, they can help others do it. Level 6, they can do it themselves, and fully they can take others into their team and work on that. So with each level, you can see from 4 to 10, the responsibility goes up. Now, in skilling, there are two kinds. One is short term and the other is long term. Long-term skilling is what the ITIs do, what is offered as BWork programs in some universities and skill universities. Short-term programs are those run through NSDC programs, through the PMKVY programs, through the DDG GKY programs, Deenadayal Upadhyay programs that is there. And you also have the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Kendras in the villages and in rural setups where they run short-term programs. Along with it, you have a special entrepreneurship short-term program called PMUR run by NISBID. an institute under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So when we come to regulator, there is one regulator at the national level, which actually is recently launched by the Ministry of Skill Development through an act of parliament. It is called the NCVET. Within the NCVET, you have the DGET, the Directorate General of Employment and Training, the Exterior Labor and Employment Department, which actually offers courses for ITIs. Whereas for all the short-term courses, most of it, the course and content is designed by NSDC. Now, when we come to the relevance of the levels of courses that we can take up at Bharati, I would say you can pitch it a course at level 4 and level 5. And if it is for entrepreneurship, you can offer a course at level 6. Talking about some popular courses that are run within Tamil Nadu, the most popular courses are in telecom and apparel industry, and to a certain extent in the leather industry. Coming to some generic courses, you should here know that if you go into the NSDC website, you have all of the qualification packs, which we call QPs, and all of the modules within the qualification packs, which we call National Occupational Standards, available for free online. So there are totally 2,424 qualification packs available on the NSDC site, and which spans across 38 sector skill councils. Now, these sector skill councils, to give you an example, is you have one for tourism, you have one for apparel, you have one for hydrocarbons, you have one for construction, you have the leather sector skill council, you have the green job sector skill council. So like this, you have 38 sector skill councils. Since it is a women's institution, and since it is an institution where you can garner the potential of various NGOs like Tech Mahindra, Quest Alliance, Tata Trust, I shall be very happy to support you to bring links and give you contacts and bring in a synergy with these institutes, who actually come with a package of a host of corporate companies who actually invest through them in CSR. And Quest Alliance has a special wing dealing with women empowerment. So that could be a very big advantage for Bharati, which we have been actually thinking of for quite some time now. I come back to it, there are 2,424 qualification packs, and there are 13,541 national occupational standards within these 2424 QPs. And exceptional national occupational standards, you have 6824 in number. So what I mean to say here is, all you could do is not start everything from scratch. You could go to this website. I would like to focus on three different sector skills here, which might be generally important to us. First is the Sports, Physical Education and Fitness Sector Skill Council, where you have at level 4 courses for a fitness trainer, physical training and sports coaching. You may not have too much to invest on this, because we already have a physical training department within the college, and there is also a PD, so you could take it up. And there is another most important one, the general one, through the Management, Entrepreneurship and Professional Skills Sector Skill Council, where you can think about courses for employability training. There is also one on a general sector skill council where media and entertainment, you could train them on voiceover artists, ad or sales coordinator. There is also the tourism sector skill council, which could give you avenues for training for front office management, front office assistants, guest and relations manager, and things like that. But all I would like to stress on is, look for programs and align it with a particular level, because NSQF is something that is recognizable across the world. So somebody who does a short-term training has a certificate in a particular sector, applies for a job, actually is recognized for employment across the globe. The descriptor which says that she can perform this particular role at this particular level. And also there are a series of loans available through Government of India, which as women, if they are trained in entrepreneurial skill for the different employment opportunities available in North Chennai or around Chennai or in the neighborhood, that could also help them start small ventures too. And coming back to Bharati Women's College and the different departments that we have, there are also some short-term programs. If you go through NSDC website on vegetable carving and things like that, which we already have been doing. So you might customize and do it and take it to the next level by not just doing it for competitions, which we normally have a competition and award the child, but they could do it professionally too. I think with this, I should stop here and open the forum for questions, please.
Thank you, ma'am, for the informative talk. Now the floor is open for discussion.
Jai Sudha, ma'am, this is Nitya from Chemistry Department. For the training programs, do the students should approach the center directly or through the college they have to come and get the information? Or will it be available in the websites?
I think, are you talking about the students who come to the Center for Women Empowerment in Bharati?
No, ma'am. Generally, I'm asking.
See, all of these qualification packs and NOSIS, the National Occupational Standards, are available free on NSDC website. It is downloadable. They also have for a certain number of NOSIS model curriculums also on how it actually should look like. And there is one thing that you need to think of when you offer skill training at a particular NSQF level, where it is only 20 to 25% theory and the rest is practical. The onus is on practical and doing things and not on theory alone. The theory is only as much as is essential to perform that particular practical task. Hope I've answered your question.
Any age limit is there, ma'am, for applying for this training program?
Training program through whom?
Through that MSDE.
No, NSDC is the National Skill Development Corporation. Yeah. It's actually a quasi-government organization, which is a PPP model, public-private partnership model, where Government of India has 49.5% share, the rest is through the industry. So they come with an industry interface where most of the qualification packs across all the 38 sectors is designed with industries by the NSDC. For short term alone. Since our focus is on short term, I thought I should stress on that.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Any other questions, participants?
Good morning to one and all. Good morning to Jai Sudha, ma'am. I'm Radhalakshmi from Botany Department. Our college is having a Go Green Club. Is there any skill-based program for getting trained for the students regarding their gardening work or in the maintenance of garden or bringing up like that? Is there any courses available or short-term course or something? Will you tell
yes.
me that it will be easy for our students to get trained with the short-term course?
Yes, Dr. Rajalakshmi, it is available. All NSDC courses are at the 10th plus level. So you can take any QP and NOS from there and customize it to it. And there is a specific course on gardener itself. nsdc.org. Or you can just Google and see QPs and NOS, qualification packs and NOAs from NSDC. You will get it.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. It's a public resource.
Okay. Thank you, Jayasudha ma'am, for your informative talk and for giving us the clarifications. Now, I request the gathering to witness a video that will be played, which portrays the role of this prestigious institution. Nitya ma'am?
எல்லோருக்கும் வணக்கம். தங்கள் அனைவரையும் பாரதி மகளிர் கல்லூரியின் யூடியூப் சேனலுக்கு அன்போடு So far, we have done many programs for students and faculty. But today, we have come here for the benefit of the women in the society at large. பெண்மை வாழ்க என்று கூத்திடுவோமடா, பெண்மை வெல்க என்று கூத்திடுவோமடா என்று பாடிய பாரதியின் பெயரால் விளங்கும் எம் கல்லூரியில் அவன் பாடிய புதுமை பெண்ணை உருவாக்க களம் இறங்கி பெண்களுக்காக ஒரு மையத்தை துவங்கியுள்ளோம். மகளிர் மேம்பாட்டு மையம், Center for Women Empowerment. According to அதர்வ வேதா, women were considered to be the embodiment of great virtue and wisdom. So we felt it is our duty to contribute our part to the women's society. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without the fear of the future, says Bible. எமது கல்லூரி பழம்பெரும் கல்லூரி, வங்கக்கடலின் அலையோசையில் எங்கள் கூடாரத்திலிருந்து பறந்து சென்ற பட்டாம்பூச்சிகளின் ரிங்காரம் வெளியில் கேட்காமலேயே போய்விட்டது. சோதனைகளை சாதனைகளாய் மாற்றி வானத்து நட்சத்திரமாய் ஜொலிக்கும் எமது முன்னாள் மாணவியர் சிலர் இதோ உங்கள் பார்வைக்காக.
வணக்கம். நான் டாக்டர் பாரதி மகோகரன், வெலிங்டன் சீமாட்டி கல்வியியல் மேம்பாட்டு நிறுவனத்தின் முதல்வர் பொறுப்பில் பணியாற்றி பணி நிறைவு அடைந்துள்ளேன். ஏறத்தாழ 32 ஆண்டு காலமாக வரலாற்று பேராசிரியராக பணியாற்றியுள்ள பெருமை அத்தகு பெருமைக்கு களம் அமைத்து கொடுத்தது பாரதி மகளிர் கலைக்கல்லூரியே.
I'm happy to connect with you all, as I am also an alumna of this college. I did my master's in English here. That was way back when Ms. Kamala was the principal and Vedavalli was the head of the English department.
Good morning, everyone. Devi, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, KCS Kasinadar College of Arts and Science. I feel it's my immense pleasure of Bharathi Women's College. I did my BCom program during the year 1992 to 1995.
Hello everyone, I'm Shobha KN. I now teach at Anna University, Gindi campus in Chennai. But then I'm a very proud alumnus of Bharathi Women's College because that is where I started my education. I did my BA in English there.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. S. Velmadi. I completed my chemistry from Bharathi Women's College 1992-93. After my BSc, I completed my MSc from Presidency College and PhD University of Madras, postdoctoral fellowship from Japan. Currently, I am serving as a professor and head Department of Chemistry, National Institute of Technology, Tiruchirappalli, one of the premier institutes in the country and a top ranked institute.
This is Dr. Bobula, alumnus of Bharathi Women's College. I did my undergrad and postgrad in the Department of Chemistry and graduated in the year 2008. After my master's, I got postdoctoral fellowship to do my PhD. I did my PhD in the area of biomaterials. So to my credit, I have published several international journals, scientific articles. I got 8 best paper awards for my research area. After my PhD, I did my postdoctoral research from IIT, Indian Institute of Technology, which is in Kharagpur, West Bengal. Collaboratively, I worked with University of Pittsburgh in Pennsylvania. So currently, right now, I am working in National Institute of Medical Science, NIMS University, in the Department of Chemistry as an associate professor in it. So this is all because of our professors, our faculty members who are there in the department.
I am Muthumani, Assistant Law in a Corporation. I have completed my BCom graduation at Bharti Women's College in 1995 batch, and in continuing with that, I have completed my BA graduation in 1998.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. C. Deepa, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Bharti Women's College. I'm glad and feel honored to be a faculty of this very same department where I did my UG degree in the year 2001. I still cherish my pleasant memories of my college days.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mandakini, working as Assistant Professor at Center for Nanoscience and Technology, Anna University. In the year 2006, and as a proud alumni, I take this opportunity to represent the voice of a common, rural, and economically weaker section of students as they form the major percentage of population at Bharti Women's College.
எல்லாருக்கும் வணக்கம். என்னுடைய பெயர் முனைவர் தீன்யா நித்யா. நான் எஸ்ஆர்எம் பல்கலைக்கழகத்தில் பயோடெக்னாலஜி டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்டில் இணைய பேராசிரியர் மற்றும் துறை தலைவர பணியிலும் இந்த சென்டர் ஃபார் விமன் எம்பவர்மெண்ட் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் ப்ரோக்ராமுக்கு வந்து ஒரு வாழ்த்துறை கொடுங்க மேம், ஆஸ் அ அலுமினி ஒரு வாழ்த்துறை கொடுங்கன்னு டாக்டர் மேடம் வந்து என்ன அப்ரோச் பண்ணாங்க. அப்ப முதல்ல எனக்கு நினைவுக்கு வந்தது வந்து பாரதி மகளிர் கல்லூரி. அதில் எனக்கான நினைவுகள் பாரதி மகளிர் கல்லூரி பத்தி சொல்லணும். 1999 நான் வந்து அங்க வந்து பிஎஸ்சி பயோகெமிஸ்ட்ரி ஜாயின் பண்ணேன்.
வணக்கம், வாழ்க வளமுடன். I'm Dr. Vijayalakshmi and I'm very proud to introduce myself as an alumni of Bharati Women's. I pursued my BSc chemistry in Bharati Women's and passed out in 91.
Hi, good evening to all. I'm very glad to introduce myself in front of you. Thanks for giving this opportunity, ma'am. I am Dr. Vijayalakshmi. Finishing my UG in the year of 2005 in Bharati Women's College, I pursued my MSc and MPhil in the year. I completed my PhD in the year of 2015 in Physics from University of Madras. Presently, I am sitting as a Head of Physics Department in Thiruthangal Nadaga College, Chennai. After I completed my PhD, I got first opportunity to work as a guest lecturer in Bharati Women's College. So I started my career.
Thank you, ma'am. The link of this video will be shared in the chat box and you can watch it at your leisure. Kuputro jayeta kuchita vikumata nadavati is a phrase in Sanskrit shloka which emphasizes the importance of women and her responsibility in shaping up a nation. It means the child may be wrong or bad, but never the mother. So that is the role of a woman in different phases to bring up the nation to the greater heights. As we have come to the end of this session, I would conclude saying, here are strong women. May we know them, may we be them, and may we raise them. Now, I call upon Dr. Nitya, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, Bharati Women's College, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Respected Principal, our most valued invited guest, HODs, staff members, and our students. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, Dr. P. Nitya, on behalf of Center for Women Empowerment and Bharati Women's College, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all the speakers for raising this occasion and sharing their views, findings, opinions today towards the women empowerment. A big thank you to Dr. Kamala Selvaraj for accepting our invitation and spare her most valuable time with us and share her thoughts about women life, health and related issues. We're all inspired by your great words, ma'am. And I also thank Dr. Sridevi, who has brought her here. And we would like to thank our special invitee, Dr. Jayasudha, for sharing her thoughts about women empowerment. And she has explained what are the programs available for the entrepreneurship and skill development for our college students. And we also acknowledge our gratitude to all the HODs, staffs of Bharati Women's College for their extensive support and wishes. We would like to extend our thanks to our alumna matters who have accepted our college invitation and share their feelings and views about the college, and they have immediately sent their videos on time. So thank you to all the alumni who have accepted for this sending the videos. And finally, I would like to express our sincere thanks to all the participants, students who has involved in this program and made this program as a great success. Thank you. Thank you very much.
So thank you all participants. Now we come to the end of this program. The video link is available in the chat box.